Hi everyone, I'm Shannon's Word Girl, and today we're going to be starting an 8-part series.
Because 8 is my lucky number.
And the words that changed the world. Part 1, Alexander the Great.
So this is going to take us through the summer. It only seemed right to me to start off this series of the wars that changed the world with the first conqueror of all time, or like the first huge conqueror of all time. In this 8-part series, we are literally going to talk about the wars that changed the world, the wars that dictated where places are, just massive wars that kind of changed our lives today and made them what they are. During this series, we're going to cover battles and warriors, conquerors that really changed the course of history and made our lives what they are today. But I don't want to spoil anything else, so I'm just going to jump right into it. It only seemed appropriate to start off this journey with Alexander the Great because he was the first massive conqueror of all time. In 356 BC, a future leader was born. His name was Alexander III of Macedon. He was tutored by Aristotle the Great, who they just called Aristotle. His father trained him for battle. Alexander was influenced by the teachings of Aristotle, whose philosophy on Greek ethos did not include forcing the Greek culture on the colonized. Hence, when Alexander III became the conqueror he was, he did not take away people's ways of life or cultures. He just took away their political autonomy, aka their freedom. He was told from a young age that it was his destiny to become one of the greatest conquerors of all time. Many conquerors, many massive world conquerors, have this background of when they were a child, they were told similar things. He was told from a young age that a Greek god named Zeus was actually his father, and it was his destiny to become one of the greatest rulers of all time. And it makes you wonder how many people were told that they were going to be great conquerors and then didn't, or did it just happen every single time? At the age of 21, Alexander III of Macedon returned home after leaving for a brief period of time due to a massive argument he had with his father. Shortly thereafter, his father was assassinated in a theater. It's simply speculation, but many believe that Alexander had his father murdered because of their feud. And because Alexander was immediately given full power of Macedonia immediately after he was murdered. You know, here at the Shy Sorry Girl community, I deliver the full tea and nothing but the tea, so I just had to leave that in there. Alexander then sought revenge for the terrible attacks on Greece that the Persians had wrought. And I'm pretty sure that's the first time I've ever used the word wrought. After gaining control of the empire, he then visited Thrace, as in uno, dos, Thrace, and asked them to join forces in conquering the dominating force of Persia. Thrace declined. This unfortunately was the end of Thrace. Alexander the Great had them completely burned to the ground and then wiped off the map completely. In 333 BC, he took 40,000 troops against the Persian forces and capitalized on their mistakes and complacency. The Persian people had become lazy and disinterested in the Persian agenda. Alexander the Great capitalized on this exact thing and attacked Persia the day that he arrived. He defeated them so bad that they even had waved a white flag, and Alexander the Great totally disregarded that and continued to slaughter them as badly as he possibly could. He refused to negotiate with them because he wanted them to be the example of, hey guys, like, don't mess with me. He was only 5 feet tall, but I'm pretty sure that like everybody was much, much shorter back in the day. You know, I think a lot of people, like, that was like a normal height. Standing at just 5 feet tall, Alexander proved that his skills were elite and went on to conquer thousands of miles of land. Alexander III of Macedon wasn't always called Alexander the Great until over 100 years later, when the Romans created a play called The Haunted House. In the play, they referred to him as thus and so thus would be. It is not untrue to say that the Roman Empire and the spread of Christianity and the long centuries of Byzantium, which is the eastern continuation of the Roman Empire, were all fruits of Alexander the Great's labor. His strategy was skillful and imaginative, and he knew how to exploit the chances that arise in every battle, and claimed victory by relentless pursuit and never lost a battle. He was the first world conqueror of all time. And was he the one who showed everybody that it was even possible? Or did they just come up with it on their own? I hope you enjoyed part one of this 8-part series of the wars that changed the world. Did you know all of this about Alexander the Great? Did you know that he was named after a play? With all of your comments and anything at all, feel free to slide into my DMs. I'm always answering them 24/7. And I would really love to chat with you one-on-one about all things battle or just life related. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all of my lovely, lovely support and love that you give to me. I'm almost at 30,000 fans. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the support and love that you guys give to me. I really appreciate it. It makes my life so wonderful, and I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. I'm Shy Sword Girl. I'm Shy Sword Girl. I'm Shy Sword Girl, and don't be a bitch. Don't be a bitch.